When learning a new programming language, we usually start with a simple hello world. There's several reasons for this. First, it's a very simple starting point. It's so simple, it's really difficult to mess up. The second is to give a simple program that can be compiled to test your environment. If we can compile and run this program, it's going to eliminate other possible problems. So let's go look at hello world. We're going to ignore most of the details. For example, we'll cover the class parts of hello world later. In this lesson, we're looking at different ways you can leave notes to yourself in code. These are called comments. You're going to include them to describe your code. It makes it clear what you're trying to do. There's no effect on your application. They're ignored and get removed when you compile. Well, we're also going to look at how to compile your application. You need to know what compiling produces, how to run your program, and finally, we're going to cover a few ways to get stuff to and from the user. Now, a Java comment can be created in two ways. If you want a single line comment, use the two forward slashes. Two forward slashes say, ignore the rest of this line. When you want a comment that spans multiple lines, you need to use a forward slash followed by an asterisk. Then everything following is a comment until the compiler reaches an asterisk, followed by another forward slash. Confused? All right, that was a mouthful. Let's take a look at this in the Hello World program. To start, let's create a Java file. It's just a text file. We need to name it helloworld.java, where the H and the W are capitalized. Now the case is important because it needs to match the name that's inside the file. All right, I'm gonna do a listing and it looks like the file's there. It's time to edit it. I'm opening the file in TextWrangler. You can use whatever text editor you like. In future lessons, we'll be using an IDE. We just wanna make sure that Java works. If we do it in an IDE and there's a problem, we couldn't be sure if it was the IDE or Java. Okay, the document should be blank. The first thing I'll add is a multi-line comment. This is a comment that spans several lines. It starts with a slash asterisk and ends with an asterisk slash. The whole comment goes from line 1 down to line 10. The compiler will ignore anything you put in between the start and end. You can add anything inside it. The other comment is a single line comment. It's just two slashes. If you put comments on the next line, Java won't know what to do with it. It's going to be an error. This is just for one line comments. All right, so the next bit I'll show you, we haven't really covered yet. Unfortunately, there's no way to create a Java program without this. Just know we'll cover everything in detail later. We're adding public class Hello World with two braces. Now the braces note the beginning and the end of our class. The name Hello World must match the name of the file. That's why I said earlier the case was important. Inside the braces, we'll add our program. The start of every Java program is a method called static public void main. This has braces to start and end the method as well. Again, we'll cover this in detail later. Just know that this is the place where Java starts to run code. The part between the parentheses is important as well. Basically, that's the command line arguments we can pass to our program. Again, something we'll cover later. The important takeaway is Java starts running here at this point. To print things to the screen, we use a method called system.out.println. That's not going to make any sense to you. This is one of those chicken and the egg things. We haven't covered classes or strings yet. We will, but just know that when you call this, whatever is inside the parentheses gets printed. This is what we use to print hello world. Inside the method braces, add the statement to print to the screen. To compile our program, we type java c hello world.java. We should get no messages. And that's a good thing. When we do a listing now, look, there's two files, the Java file and a class file. The class file contains those instructions that are sent to the JVM to run. It's the result of compiling the Java file. To run the program, we type java hello world. The case is important, but we don't need to add the .class part. Java's smart enough to figure that one out. It should print hello world and then return the prompt onto the next line. Now, what if we wanted to say something else? Let's go back and change the phrase to say, hello, Gracie. We just change it, save the file, recompile it using the same Java C command, and run it again. Now it says, hello, Gracie. The last thing I want to show you is what happens when you have an error. Let's go introduce an error into our code. I'm going to remove a semicolon and we'll try compiling again. Now let's go back and compile. When we compile, we get an error. The error says a semicolon was expected. It even tells you the line the error happened. If we put the semicolon back, it should compile again. And it does. Now, what would we need to change if we wanted to ask the user their name and then say hello to the user? To get input, we use these commands. Again, it's might look like an alien language. Just know that when we use these, it prompts the user to enter something. Let's change our application to ask the user's name. Then when they hit enter, we're going to print hello user, where user is the name the user enters. It'll be clearer once we do it. Let's go to the code. Okay, first let's clear out the existing code of our program. Next, we're going to add a line to create something called a scanner. This is an object that can parse primitive types and strings. We're parsing things entered from the command line. You don't really need to follow this. Just know that these statements get input from the command line. The next line gets the text the user enters. And finally, we print out hello, whatever you typed in. Let's compile it and see it in action. Enter a name, and there it is. Hello, DJ. And on that note, let's go to the next lesson. Hey, thanks for watching the video. There's a quick quiz for this on DGU.com if you'd like to gauge how much you learned. If you like the videos you're seeing, please let me know by liking the video and hitting the subscribe button for the DGU channel on YouTube. I'd really appreciate that. If you have concerns or questions, please leave them in the comments below or on DGU.com. There's a poll on the front page of DGU.com, so you can also let me know what topic gets covered next. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.